मॉर्निंग जो है हॉर्स टाइम फॉर ट्रम्प टू रिजाइन जो है स्कारप्रॉफ एंड मेका बर्जिंस्की टेल द रैप देयर इज ओनली वन वे फॉर ट्रम्प टू गेट देम बैक इन हिज कॉर्नर। मॉर्निंग जो है को होस्ट जो है जो स्कारप्रॉफ एंड मेका बर्जिंस्की से दे आर वंस फ्रेंडली रिलेशनशिप विद डोनाल्ड ट्रम्प हैज सॉल्व्ड सो कंप्लीटली दैट देयर इज ओनली वन वे ही कैन रीगेन देयर सपोर्ट। इन ए रिसेंट इंटरव्यू विद द रैप वी आस्क्ड द कपल इज देयर एनीथिंग ट्रम्प कैन डू टू गेट यू बैक इन हिज कॉर्नर आर इज इट टू लेट ही कैन लीव। Brzezinski replied, "He can resign," said Scarborough. "That would be very helpful," added Brzezinski. "We are a long way from the days during the presidential campaign when the hosts were accused of being too cozy with Trump in February 2016." Rolling Stone's Matty Taibbi wrote that the pair should be herded into a rocket and shoot into space for their brown. Nosing of Trump, the MSNBC show was one of many outlets accused of giving Trump a platform for the sake of ratings. Scarborough and Brzezinski eventually ramped up their criticism and their relationship with Trump disintegrated in June when the president claimed Brzezinski had been bleeding badly for a facelift during a party at his Mar-a-Lago resort around New Year's Eve. The president was roundly criticized for the ugly personal attack. The recently engaged Scarborough and Brzezinski spoke with the rap last week for an inside look at the 10-year anniversary of Morning Joe. We asked them to walk us through how they so completely lost faith in the president. The rap Mika has said the personal attacks don't bother her, but what does bother her is that she's worried for the country. At what point in Trump's presidency were you the most worried, Brzezinski? It was early on, Scarborough. I could tell you that for me the first time that I realized that we could be heading directly into constitutional crisis was when he started challenging the legitimacy of federal judges. This is just something that I guess if you run golf courses your whole life, you may not understand exactly what you are doing. But when he started questioning the legitimacy of the judiciary, I started asking, well, how far does this go? Then a week or two later, he called the press enemies of the people, which of course is as Stalinist term that the Soviet Union outlawed after Stalin died. That's when we realized it was getting into even more dangerous territory. Brzezinski, who had massive reservation throughout the campaign last August on the show, Joe revealed that a top foreign policy leader had talked to Trump and Trump asked why the president couldn't use nukes. Why can't we nuke people? We were so disturbed, we revealed this on the show and we literally said, be careful America. We were very worried, and for some reason, because there was a relationship with Trump, a lot of people misunderstood that as if we were like voting for him, which did not happen in neither of our class cases. Scarborough, you can also go back to February. I wrote a column for the Washington Post and I said he was using racist tactics. I think I ended it by asking if this is how the party led by Abraham Lincoln dies. So with all that said, I think I said I could never vote for him in December of 2015 after the Muslim ban comment. Trump was sending nasty tweets about us. It got really ugly during the campaign, but I think Mika could agree with me that as bad as we thought it was going to be, as bad as people who have known him for a decade thought it was going to be, it's actually even worse. The rap, is there anything Trump can do to get you back in his corner, or is it too late? Brzezinski. He can leave Scarborough. He can resign Brzezinski. That would be very helpful. The Trump has been widely criticized for the way he handled Charlottesville. Did he ever show any signs of being a racist from a personal standpoint when you were close with him? Brzezinski, no, honestly, no. He's very kind to people. He seems really nice and funny. Scarborough, all the times that we had spent time with him, I never had him make racist comment or say racially insensitive things behind the scenes, and I always took him to be a moderate Manhattan Democratic who was the friends with Nancy Pelosi and Chuck Schumer and the Clintons and everybody else. I guess all that changed when he figured out that he could be birtherism to make inroads in the Republican Party. I think it's all just absolutely cynical, nasty blow for him, and I think it has been for the beginning of him campaign to try to win support among very dark element of the Republican Party. Unfortunately, it worked in the primaries, but it's destroying his presidency. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share my videos.